Hello and welcome to a new video of my Unity MMORPG tutorial series, and in this series we will modify our package parser. So as you can see, I use Visual Studio 2019, and I didn't upgrade the Unity engine yet, but I use the new Visual Studio version. And yeah, today let's start with changing our package parser. And yeah, let's go to our package types. And yeah, we will modify the package parser so that you can add your packets into the server and so on, so you don't need to change these variables here. This is only standard, and then you can use for plugins also in another step or in another file. Okay, and this means that we have to change our types. So we say public static class, and we delete this, and we will call this communication package value, and we will change every line of code with a public const, and this will be this one, and I will copy it to all variables we declared. And this means this variables, the const, means that this variables can't change from other code. So you declared these variables and you cannot modify it and change it in any way. So we have to change this. And the next step will be our package parser. Let's check the iPackage parser. And I guess we don't need to change anything here, but we have to change something in the base, I guess. And this will be our ID, will be uint33. And so we change all communication package to uint. And we also need to change the package type and the package attribute so that you have changed the communication package into uint33. And now we can go to our package parser. And here we have to change a lot of things. And at first we have to change the communication package to uint as in the last step, so we have to change all to uint. And okay, now we have to we start with a new function and we create a new class and we call it public class package parser options. And this will be public IE numerable. And we have to add the assembly and say assemblies get, sorry, wrong brackets, And this will be get and set. And yeah, the next thing will be a public static class package parser extensions. And this will be, I need to add a namespace, I guess, and this is the reflection. And this will be, yeah, what we do here is we create an option or a parser that checks all DLL files. So we can add a new DLL file with, I don't know, inventory system also, and you can copy it to the master server and to the client, and then we can the package parser will check if there is a class from package base, and if there is a class from package base, you can send the package. So you don't need to change the YukiNet later, and if you want that other people create packages for you, or plugins, in the later case I will create a plugin system, and then other people can modify or create extension for your MMORPG, and then they can add the package base and create the own package for your script, and this will be what we creating now. And this class will be we will add a function to our service. You will see it later if I edit the stuff, and then you can add the options to the package parser to our server. So we create a public static void add package parser, and this service collection, and this will be our service descriptors, and we create an enumerable, and this will be the assembly, and our assembly is equals to null, and as you can see our service, we need to add the dependency injections, and our service descriptors is from our config, and so we add the package parser later in the master server. So service descriptors dot add options, and this will be package parser options, and then we can say configure, and then we will use lambda expressions, and we say x.assemblies equals to assemblies, and then we can say service descriptors dot add singleton, and we can say I package parser and our package parser. This is very complicated, but I hope you will understand. And yeah, let's modify the let's start with adding stuff in our in our constructor, and this will be iOptions. And our package parser options. And we create options. I need to add the namespace using Microsoft extensions dot options. And then we say that this dot option options okay. And I need to add a read-only field. That's why we don't have the options. And this will be the package parser options. And you can say options. And then you can add this options equals to options dot value. And as you can see, this one is got another color, and so you can delete this. This one is this, and this type is this, so you can create a large L and here capital L, and as you can see, we can delete this, so you don't need the this function or the this attribute. And now we say in the resolve package we have to add this one get type dot assembly, and then we say if options dot assembly equals to null, or not if options assemblies not null, sorry, and then we can register assemblies, and we can say options dot assemblies, and this function we will create now. So we add new method called register assemblies, and we add our enumerable and say assembly and assemblies, and then we say if assemblies equals null, then we can throw new argument null exception, name of assemblies, and if not, we can ask. We can check all assemblies, so we check the variable with the for each war assembly in assemblies. And we say resolve package assembly. And okay, and now we have to change a few stuff in our resolve package, and this will be assembly, and now we have to change this line to assembly.getTypes. And as you can see, the error is gone. And we have to change the logger here with a capital L. Okay, and this was the resolve package types, and yeah, let's check the package type, and we don't need to typecast it, and we can delete this one, and yeah, that's, I guess that was everything we had to change. And now we have changed our package parser. And yeah, if we go to the packages, we have to change the communication package to communication package value. And then all our if we do this, all our packages will work again. And I will do this in all our packages, and okay, that's everything we have to change in this case, and the rest we will do. Yeah, we can add now in the master server. Let's check the program CS and do the last step. And yeah, the only thing we need to do is to go to the service descriptor. Sorry, first build our Yukinet, and then you can say add package parser. Yeah, and now you have to do change all package types in the server as well. But I think, yeah, the last thing we have to do is we have to say we have to we have to change some stuff, and this will be our package parser, but this we will do in the next video. So thank you for watching, and if you have any problems or questions, you can write it down in the comments or join my Discord server. Don't forget to subscribe me on Patreon, and yeah, if you like the videos I created, you can write it down in the comments and leave a like.